orange juice. Cheap bit of orange. Welcome back to Motorsport Manager. So in the last episode, we got a first and second. Oh yes. If I remember rightly, Daily divided the motion. Today we're in Singapore. We're not. I'm still in Ipswich, but anyway, we are in Singapore. If we look at the standings currently, we do have Tafoni at top, then Gashnang in third. Total 8 points between Tafoni and Gashnang, with Daily 3 points behind Tafoni, as you can see. And we're currently 53 points ahead of AJ Foyt Enterprises. Just nice to see. Four races left in the season. So let's push on, shall we? Let's get into this and this. How have we all been? I've been okay. You know, same old with me. You know what I'm like. Can't complain. But fuck it, I will. Let's carry on. So yeah, we're on target. Could get the promotion I'm after. Should be very fucking nice. Let's face it, it'd be very fucking nice if we can get promoted. Bring that mic a little bit closer. Not too fucking close though, but a little bit closer. Yeah. I'm just waiting for this to load. It's been a while since I played this. It seems like it takes forever to load. Don't know why. It doesn't. It's a lot quicker than it was with the old computer. Anyway, let's get these cars set up, shall we? I feel a bit lost, actually. I say it's been a little while since I played this. I've been playing other things. I've been trying out Black Desert Online. I've been trying out Citadel, Forge of Fire. I have playthroughs for both of those at the minute. I haven't decided what I'm going to do yet. It's either going to be The Witcher 3, it's either going to be Black Desert Online, or it's going to be Citadel. I've got a few episodes of each coming out over the next few weeks. For you guys who are watching both this and that, let me know which ones you'd rather see. It's only going to be one of the three that I'm going to do. You might get occasional extra episodes of other ones out of me, but I'm only going to pick one of them. Just let me know which one you'd rather see. Let's get these cars out then. We've got them all set up nicely. Oh, orange really. It's not orange juice. I had a orange and it's quite repeating a little bit. It was lovely orange. Really, really free. Let's get these cars out then. Get them on the track. Now for the probably cool. Last time we were here, I think we got our first place out of frame. Was that the situation last season? The first place in crash? I think it was Gomez crash before we got first place somewhere. Was it around? I know we definitely got first place. Not very in fact, I think it saved our season last season, that particular effort. So let's bring both these guys in. Let's bring the guy and the girl in. Just have to give their air. It's a mint one this week. It's a mint era this week. Just like the Americans' heads, Canadians. Sorry. car setup. The handling's no good, but everything else is alright. Well, we can sort that out. I think that'll do the job. And then Tafoni, we just need to work on the era a little bit. He's gone for an orange era this week. I don't see them often, but they are pretty good. We'll try that and see what happens there. Yeah. You go on in and out. They are sometimes. But I mean, I can't complain. I got paid for basically sitting in a room for 5 hours. Maybe I've done a little bit of that. I basically sat down and played my DS. I'm doing the one mod for my DS. It's a little bit difficult when the internet's been sporadic. You can't really catch Pokemon. The idea is you want to trade it off for the one lot, and once the Pokemon's dead, the Pokemon gets made and it's dead. And so you get no internet. Or the internet's like really, really sketchy. It's really difficult to trade off a Pokemon, so fairly good human being. Managed a few, though. Not anything particularly exciting. Nothing exciting at all. I did get a magic cup, which I turned into a Gyarados, and then that got killed. Very, very sort of silly decision by me, should we say. Outside of that, I've got fuck all decent so far. I've got a Wurmple. They're terrible. I mean, they really are terrible. I just can't even remember what's in my team at the minute. What's that? I'm not talking about Pokemon, I'm doing my score. I don't know, I've got a Swellow. I've got a Swellow. Which isn't a bad Pokemon for this. Yeah, that's better. Yes, we can. It's probably about right there. Try that one out. So, got a Ferrocene. Oh, a Sableye. Sableye was my starter Pokemon, effectively, so I switched down to start Pokemon for the Sableye was really comfortable, actually. Unfortunately, it was level 1. So we start the game again. It was level 1. As it's Ghost type, usually in the first area of normal types, Ghost type moves and normal type moves, they don't hit each other. So if you've got a Ghost type and normal type, you can't get Ghost. Sableye was supposed to end up. The dark type moves. So I was smashing shit with the normal type moves, which was helpful. We've got level 3 for race trim and for the soft tyres. I'm not going to be able to get anything else from that. Nice fire, that's fine. Big as good. Nice speeds coming in. Obviously, we are developing more brakes as well this season. Trying to get some brakes. Especially if we're going to get promotional, because it's going to be a big jump up in class. I would not be surprised if we get relegated. If we get promoted. I mean, we've got to get promoted first. How much uni is right now that we get promoted? The way things are going, we won't. But we'll get a couple more decent results. I think two decent results, especially the last race of the season, where I think it's double points. We've got Rio's here. So is Jonathan Edwards, though. At least Marcel's not here. I mean, Jonathan Edwards a rarity in comparison to Marcel. Soft tyre sweet spots and soft tyre sweet spots. This car setup. Yeah, they'll do, won't they? Car setup wise, that'll do perfectly. Off we fuck. Alright, Yaknang, you go first, girl. Toss is going to be one of the faster cars around. Again, the Toss is going to be one of the faster cars around. Frost is pretty damn quick. Daly and Thomas are probably the two we need to be concerned about the most. Fully, this man. Gatling's a decent man. Toss is a decent man. Daly's slower than us at the minute. Weather's looking good still. Casanave, I knew there was going to be someone. I was like, yeah. No, Casanave. The Forney got the fastest lap, even though his sort of outgoing was really, really poor. That's not too bad, though. Right? Tire choices. We'll get you on another set of these. Get you back out there. You. We'll do the same again with you. New set of tyres. Don't need to worry about changing setup. Tweaks and Gatling, obviously. Gatling's getting pushed further down. Expected, I guess. So we'll go in between two E's for both drivers, I think. and it's out, they've both gone out at the same time. Let's pause, lovely. There we go. There we go. And make sure they're all the way down. Lovely stuff. See how that goes through. Perfect brake. Perfect brake. Bang. Should be faster laps. Should feel it. The 40's not that far behind Cazenave, so hopefully with the perfect brakes, he's a little bit faster. He is a little bit faster. Gatlin's a little bit faster. If we can get first and second here in qualifying, we have definitely dropped. Before he does go top, Gatlin gets himself back up to third, which it's an improvement. Obviously, it's an improvement, but you know, it's an improvement. It's Horny, just smashed back, absolutely fucking smashed back. That is good to see. It's just about now. I'm sure. Get Gatlin ahead of Cazenave. If we do that, it's in the back. Thomas and Daly, as long as they do perform, hopefully one of them will match. As long as they do perform, they'll do it alright. I want to get to it so that we don't have to worry about winning on the last day of the season, because I'll say, I think I'm pretty sure it's double points. Aaron Andrews is here. James Martin's here. It's not Martin Haven, it's James Martin. I've mentioned it before. Jonathan Edwards is back, is he? Jonathan Edwards thinks he's Marcel Desailly these days. Turning up everywhere. I say, you don't see him for ages and he turns up twice. I'll be back again on the next bit. Race trim soft tyres. I think we'll have to worry about quick fixes. Race trim soft tyres again. Weather forecast looks good, although not for us, obviously. Driver setup. Okay. That's 96. It's not really an improvement. But just looks like an improvement. We'll take this soft. 33 laps. So it's going to have to be a two-stopper. Okay, if we go 11 laps on both sets of tyres, if we take 14 laps of fuel, yeah, we'll take 13 laps of fuel. We'll give it to 14. So this setup's okay. It's only 95%, surprisingly. Take those tyres, give you 15 laps of fuel. So if we go 11 laps for Gatlin, 12 for DeForney, or should we do 11? We'll go 11 for DeForney, 12 for Gatlin, and then go another 11 laps. I know what I'm on about. So, DeForney, Cazenave, Gatlin, Spat, Ed Carpenter, and Josie Thomas in the front five here. So, I've gone for an attacking push off. Hopefully, we can get some straight down to the end here. Go to DeForney as an easy first place. Gatlin's dropped down fourth and then fifth. try to get him in for lap 11. Try to get him in for lap 12. And a minute fuel wise for the let's get if we need to go a little bit higher on the fuel. Especially if we're going to go for 11 actually. And that gear has dropped by 1.5 seconds. So I'm going to just grab that 2 minutes. That's my little advantage. That's my advantage. I've been a failure. Then it would have been beneficial. if we get the point to do just one more lap, get you out on these. 23 laps remaining, so if we do 11 and then 12, I guess. Take a bit of extra fuel. Everything's fine, we take it safe, fast. Close enough to attack. Battling. Mixing first. We'll take a balanced. Then obviously Cat and Angle coming from next time. We'll hold on to it to form its boost. Boost. It's up to nearly 7 seconds now. Back into the just about survived in the fuel just got. Has an idea shit for the work up there. Yeah, it's got the work. Definitely stay ahead of serving, I guess. Come around the line. But do stay ahead of serving. Just have 8 seconds on Turby. Turby's still got a funny hit. So it should, theoretically, be a double podium. Or a double podium if you want. It should theoretically be a double podium. That has to be the four new gap is the four new gap. Looking at really 9 seconds. So, making sure the untouched words, nothing happens. Financially at the minute, we don't have £7 million in bank, so it's 1.4 million of us if we hit sponsorship objectives. So we don't have a huge amount of money for four races. We do have some sponsorships coming up soon, but I think, as I said in the previous episode, I'm going to go back to the road. I am going to build more bank points. Same order, side. Horny seems to be happy enough. Horn 30. Yeah, it's from 7 to 10. To 11. 11 laps now. We won't risk it. We'll take these. We'll give him 13 laps. There we go. Now for this lap. See if we can get ourselves across. We'll risk it. We're going to risk it for a biscuit. We're going to risk it for a fucking biscuit, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go to overtake now. We've got a nice gap here. Rocket scientists are going to get something down through, so bang bang. start the front wing itself. Before he does win, Gatling does come third, so we do get a double podium again. Hopefully, like the last race, Cazenave has broken some rules. Please, Cazenave, please do something illegal. He doesn't. Oh, fuck's sake. So, fastest lap does go to Ed Carpenter, who did get a drive-through penalty. Still a fastest lap, though, didn't he? So, we get another 20 points, get another 38 points, actually. So the 40 is still top, 8 points clear. Gakkenen is only 2 points behind Daly now. And we're sitting 59 points at the top, clear. Pardon me, bit of a burp there. So that is good to see, that is very fucking good to see. When you consider that we're 122 points ahead of 5th and our target is 4th, I don't think there's going to be a problem somehow. So, I'm really disappointed there's been no Superior at all this episode. Not a single sight of leather-clad buttocks at all. It's been disappointing. I mean, the win's great. The third place is great, but it's disappointing there are no leather-clad buttocks. Not mine, I don't wear leather. Anyway, the 40 stats have increased. It's really weird, Gakkenen's got this thing where one of her traits, these guys don't improve as much. I'm wondering if I might replace her for next season. I do want to replace her for next season. She's been a good driver this season. We come first as well. So chairman's happy, 300%, so it doesn't make any difference. Our marketability is now up to 50%. We lost 1.44 million. So we've got what, 3 races left after this one, is it? Is it 3? So that's 4.2. Let's round up to 4.4 because of the extra bits. So yeah, 3 races. So 4.4. We've got a little bit of money to play with, I guess. Interview the BBC, except the interview because it's Susie Perry. He's the partner. Still happy. You've got a rival with your teammate now. Driver will not renew your contract. Why do you want to drive with the team? That lasts 52 weeks, you've got 28 months, and you've got 3 months. You know your contract, and you want to keep him. So it's... So he's currently on $333,000. We're off from this, he wants a short contract. A lot of patience, so we'll see how it works out. Anyway, guys. 2 more races to go and then we can get to each new sponsor. That is going to be the end of today's episode. I'm not going to show you the brakes or anything. You can see those at the start of next episode. If you have enjoyed today's episode, of course, please do like and subscribe. If you think we should get rid of Gap Name, then of course, please do let me know in the comments below. And yeah, I'll see you.